Right now, I'm going to show you how to do dodging and burning using the new adjustment tool in Photoshop. I asked you guys if you wanted a more in-depth tutorial. A lot of you said yes, so here we go. Currently, this is only available in the beta version of Photoshop. So I'll give you a link if you don't know how to install the beta. So let's grab the adjustment brush. So if we go down under the brushes, you'll see that it's nested there. And we're going to grab the adjustment brush and we're going to start with brightness and contrast. Now I'm just going to tap to activate it. Now when I activate it, what you'll see is an adjustment layer with a layer mask. And yes, this does work the same as brushes and adjustment layers with masks, but it's just quicker and simpler to use. So just to show you how some of the settings work, we're going to take the brightness and we're going to turn it all the way up. You'll see that in the properties panel, and that it corresponds with the adjustments here in the layers panel. Okay, so what we need is some brush settings. So we're going to select the brushes, and I'm going to be using the soft round brush. Now, if you're using something like a Wacom tablet, Xencelabs, Microsoft Surface, something that has a pressure sensitive pen, you have the ability to change some things based on how hard you press. Let me show you how to set that up as well. Now, you'll see two settings here. If I click, this will change it for size. So if I'm pressing hard, I'll get a thicker stroke. If I press lighter, I'll get a thinner stroke. And this enables me to kind of create different types of effects. Now, if the other one is turned on, this is opacity. So that means if I'm pressing hard, we're going to get a lot of adjustment. If I press lighter, we get less. And this enables us to do things like blend things in. And this is very, very nice for dodging and burning. In fact, if you get a pressure sensitive tablet, I would get it just for this purpose, to be able to blend when you're doing your dodging and burning. Don't worry if you're using a mouse, this tutorial will still apply to you. All right, but let's have a look at how we can have more settings than just using these two buttons up here, although this will get you most of the way there. If we go under Window, and then we turn Brush Settings on, this will bring up the adjustments here. And under the Brush Settings, we have the ability to set opacity based on pen pressure. Notice it transfers, it shows pen pressure set to opacity. Notice what happens if I turn it off. See how it turns it off in the panel? And if I turn on size, it will appear under shape dynamics. So this is just a shortcut to access these settings, but these will, but when you go into the settings themselves, you've got more control. So we can choose shape dynamics and we can choose pen pressure. But now when we're in here, we have the ability to say, hey, we want a minimum diameter, meaning don't go any thinner than this. Same thing when we go under the transfer, we have the ability to set a minimum amount of opacity as well as, you know, lots of other settings in here. Now, a couple of key things. You can use size and opacity at the same time. So if I do, that means if I press light, I get a thin stroke and it's light. And as I press harder, it gets thicker and more solid. This might have its purposes. I find it very difficult to work with both of those turned on at the same time. So most of the time, I'm going to be using transfer. Now, if you change brushes, these settings can change. If you hit that little lock, that will lock them in. So it doesn't matter what brush you use, transfer will be locked on all the time. And if you're getting any value out of this video, hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications, you won't miss any of my videos. But for the sake of this tutorial, let's use the setting up here. Now, there's another setting that's really important, and that's the flow. Now, I've done another video on flow versus opacity, and I've determined that for dodging and burning, flow works the best. So what we're going to do is we're going to drop this down to about 10%. I can drag, or I can do it faster using the keyboard shortcuts. If you hold down the shift key and tap 1, that'll give you 10%. You can do an increments of 10 by tapping 6 for 60%. 0 will give you 100%. Or if you want to do a smaller amount, just quickly tap 08 and that'll give you 8%. Remember, hold down the shift key will adjust the flow. Otherwise, we're adjusting the opacity. And usually for flow, I find if you really want to be able to paint subtly, you want something around about an 8 or even a 7 to 10%. And notice what happens as I'm brightening this area. Now I can just slowly build this up in a much more realistic fashion. Let's look at the strategy for dodging and burning now, and then I'll show you some great tips at the end of that. So what we're going to do is we're just going to start again, and we're going to do two adjustments. We're going to do lighten and darken. Now, under the adjustments, we have the ability to use exposure or brightness contrast. I feel like brightness contrast works the best, but I'll also show you a way to test it on the exposure. Okay, so what we want to do is look at this image and think about where is the light coming. The light's coming from over here on the left, which is where the sun is. So all the areas that are facing that light should receive light and get brightened. The areas such as here that are shaded from that light or facing the opposite direction should get shadow. And by blending in that light and shadow, we can add a lot of depth to this image. Okay, so with the brightness and contrast, we're going to start with the light first. So I'm just going to tap on an area I know is going to be brightened. And once again, this is just going to open up our adjustment layer. I'm going to turn the brightness all the way up so we can easily see what's happening. Now, don't worry if you overdo it because we can adjust opacity later. All right, so now I'm going to go with the brush. Now, there's another keyboard shortcut. Is if I hold down the Control Option key on Mac and I drag side to side, I can change the size of the brush or I can go up and down to change the hardness. If you're working on Windows, that's the Alt right drag. So that's a useful thing to know. The other way you can do it is with the bracket key. Left bracket key makes it smaller, right bracket key makes it bigger. All right, so let's go ahead and start to paint some lighter areas in here. Now I'm starting with that low opacity, but see how when we go into that grass, see how now it just starts to come alive. And these are the areas that are going to be receiving the light because they're facing towards the sun. And here I'm going to use a bigger brush just to kind of get some of the areas like the water. I'm not going to do all the water. I'm going to be pretty strategic with that. I definitely want to get that brighter part here to kind of lighten that up and a little bit in the sky. Now I'm using a big brush. Now here's the thing. If you use a larger brush, you'll start to get more of a painterly effect. If you use a smaller brush, you can get a more kind of chiseled look. Okay, so that's the big areas I'm just kind of hitting here. Now I'm going to go really small and start to do some details. All right, if we look at what we've done, here we are before and after we've added some light. Now, if it's too much, we can adjust the opacity. All right, what we want to do now is we want to create a shadow layer. So let me just select the background. And the reason I'm doing that is because I'm going to use the same adjustment and all I need to do is just tap now and that'll create a second instance of this. Now we're going to take the brightness, we're going to turn it all the way down because we want to darken. Now remember, we'll make some adjustments at the end where we'll do some fine tuning. All right, so first thing I want to do is a larger shadow area. So I'm going to use a larger brush and I'm just going to gently paint in some of these areas. I want to add a little shadow. And now I'm going to use a smaller brush and go in and do the fine details. Okay, let's have a look and see what we've done. Here's the highlight areas and here's the shadow areas. If I turn them on, you can see them. If I turn them off, you can see. And notice in these areas around here. I'm going to take the opacity all the way up on both of these. And now I can adjust them using the brightness and contrast. So for the shadows, we can adjust how much shadow we want. And we can also adjust the amount of contrast. I'm going to have a pretty high contrast for the shadow. Let's grab the highlights. Let's bring the contrast down a little bit on the highlights. And then adjust the brightness for where we want. The reason I'm doing that is just to kind of make it so we're not losing the color here in the water. And if we look at this, here we are before and after. So here's the thing, I don't have to paint everything again. Let me show you. So say I wanted to do an exposure for the highlights. I'm going to hit an exposure and just tap. That'll create an exposure layer. So here's a highlight area. I'm just going to turn it off. And if I grab the mask from the highlight and I hold down the Alt or the Option key and I drag that, I can replace the mask inside the exposure. And if we like the adjustment maybe on the land, but we don't like it over the water, we can simply choose to paint black inside the mask over the water. And we can change the foreground to the background, or we can just hit the minus key up there and that will select black. Let's grab a large brush here, and now we can just start to paint away that adjustment, still using that pen pressure on the flow until we get to the amount that we like. So we're just reducing it, but not completely eliminating it. And that gives us a different kind of an effect. So let's look at another quick tip I want to show you guys here. And that's when we're dealing with straight lines. So say we're going to paint with an exposure setting. Let me hit the left bracket key to make this brush smaller. And we're going to apply some highlights to the left side of these columns. So I could try to paint on here. And not too bad. But here's an easier way to do it. Once I start to paint, hold down the shift key and that will constrain it into that line. And therefore I don't have to worry about trying to have a steady hand. I just follow that edge there and it'll keep a straight line there. Very, very easy to do. Let's just do these top ones quickly. And then same thing when I want to do the shadows. Select here, grab another exposure adjustment by simply tapping. This time we're going to take it down. We're going to take the exposure down low. And let's start in the shadow side. Hold the shift key, constrain us, and I can just paint that shadow in. Look at that. Start to paint it, hold down that shift key, we get that constraint. And I'm using that pen pressure and just using a small amount of pressure. I'm going to show you one more tip once I've done this area here. So I'm just trying to paint that in a little bit. Okay, so sometimes to add some shadow, now I can go for a larger brush and paint even softer or even turn that flow down lower. If, you know, and if you're using a mouse, keep that flow down quite low. And you can just start to build up some of these shadows in these areas of that bigger brush. And it just kind of blends things together, adds a little bit of kind of a shadow effect in there. And we can just build that up over time. All right, so if we look at these pillars, what we've done before and after, there we are before, and there we are after. So I hope you found this tutorial useful. Drop a comment underneath and let me know if you did. And by the way, I have other tutorials on dodging and burning using the standard way with brushes. Check out that tutorial right there. And if you're new to the cafe, welcome. Hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications. You won't miss any of my tutorials. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.